The 1930s to 1970s was known as the period of depressed conditions. The stock market had just recently failed in 1929, and the whole country was in a state of economic depression known as the heyday. The heyday was a time period of like progressive thought. So people use economic depression to show how the schools were failing. Many people blame secondary schools and said that the curriculum's too rigid and that there's not enough choices provided. And actually, the National Education Association Committee conducted two classic research studies. One of the studies that I'm going to touch on today is going to be the 8-year study. So in this 8-year study, it involved high schools, some traditional high schools and some creative and experimental high schools. So there's two set of schools. At the traditional school, teachers were supposed to treat the students like normal, continue with the strict rules and regulations. And then at the other school, the experimental school, teachers were encouraged to be very creative, and there were many things that these teachers and students didn't have to do at the creative school. After 4 years, students were compared from both schools, and it was actually found that when it came to the basic knowledge, there was no real difference in the grade point average. And 4 more years into college, there was another comparison made, and there was still no differences. So the end thought is that, traditional versus progressive, is there's really no difference and very little change. But one thing that this 8-year study did do is that it contributed towards more flexible approaches in the high school curriculum.